As I mentioned earlier, without a record company set to release Bat Out of Hell, Todd had persuaded Bearsville to bankroll the recording of the album. The theory was it would then be taken around to various labels, and whoever released it would pay back the recording expenses to Bearsville. But this wasn't as simple as it sounds. Todd knew they had a great record, but not many agreed, and it appeared that no one else could hear its potential. For close to 6 months, the Meatloaf Steinman Rundgren opus fell on deaf ears. But then Steve Popovich, president of a little label called Cleveland International, heard it. He decided to take a chance and signed it. We know what happened next. And Steve, we got a couple of the original multitracks from Bat Out of Hell. Later in the program, we'll look at Paradise by the Dashboard Light. But for now, it's the title track that Todd was just talking about, isn't it?
That's right. Todd arranged for us to get a digital copy of the original 24-track master tapes. And as he himself mentioned, many of the songs on the Bat Out of Hell sessions were captured as live performances, including many of the lead vocals. And as a result, there's quite a lot of spill from the various instruments across many of the microphones. Now, there were overdubs made, especially the backing vocals, and I'll highlight some of those in a moment, but let's start at the top of the track. And for many fans of this song, the opening piano motif is really an iconic intro part. Now, the sound is actually created by several instruments, two acoustic piano parts and an organ. The original piano and organ were recorded as part of the backing track, with a further track of piano and fuzz synthesizer overdubbed. There's even a tubular bell added halfway through, so let's take a listen.
One, two, three.
I'll pan the original piano to the left channel and add in the overdub piano on the right-hand channel. Now I'll blend in the organ and synthesizer. And at this point, I'll solo the tubular bell. And what every great rock track needs, a gong. Next, I'll bring in the drums, great classic rock drum part. Followed by the bass. Next, a pair of Todd's guitar tracks. Now a second pair. The high part has the delay effects recorded to tape. Mixed back in with the organ synth tracks, this is a great composite sound. At this point, Todd added timpani to great effect. Hear how it enhances the pattern. Now, if you listen very carefully, you can hear the drummer count time with his sticks. Vitally important on a song like this, with so many tempo changes and time signature changes. Next, I'm going to bring in the ooze. This is a stereo pair, but bounced down from a multi-tracked performance. Now the backing vocals. These take up three tracks, a stereo pair with an additional shouts track.
Like a bat out of hell, I'll be gone when the morning comes.
Now mixed back in the track.
When the night is over, like a bat out of hell, I'll be gone, gone, gone. Like a bat out of hell, I'll be gone when the morning comes.
Next, it's Meatloaf's lead vocal, and there are two tracks on this tape. the original vocal performance recorded with the backing track, and an overdub take. First, I'll solo the original track, and you can hear the spill from the band.
I'm gonna hit the highway like a battering ram on a silver black Phantom bike. Oh, when the metal is hot and the engine is hungry, I'm all about to see the light. Nothing ever grows in this rotten old hole, and everything is stunted and lost. And nothing really rocks. And nothing.
Now I'll switch over to the overdub track, a much drier sound and with no spill.
And I know that I'm damned if I never get out, and maybe I'm damned if I do. But with every other beat I got left in my heart, you know I'd rather be damned with you.
Well, if I got on this section of the track, Ellen Foley sings two-part with Meatloaf. First, her soloed vocal.
If I gotta be damned, you know I wanna be damned. Gotta be damned, you know I wanna be damned.
Both.
Gotta be damned, you know I wanna be damned.
Dancing through the night.
And now the backing vocals. I think her vocal tone, along with Todd's backing vocals, really helped create the overall trademark sound of this album. Let's hear them isolated.
Oh, baby, you're the only thing in this whole world that's pure and good and right. And wherever you are and wherever you go, there's always gonna be some light. But I gotta get out, I gotta break it out now, before the final crack of dawn.
And in the track.
So we gotta make the most of our one night together. When it's over, you know we'll both be so alone.
Add in Meatloaf's lead vocal across the ooze. The lead vocal track I'm playing here is from the take recorded with the band, slightly different from the master vocal used.
Been like a sinner before the gates of heaven, up and rolling on back.
Now it's Todd's famous motorbike guitar. This is the original sound, as recorded onto the multitrack. The finished master has extra stereo delay and reverb added. I'll also mix a bit of the second guitar in. And now fade it all back into the master.
Bat Out of Hell. One of the most successful albums of all time. According to a Reuters business report last year, it sold a total of 43 million units worldwide since its release.